Now, if we took the simple way the Bible presents itself, it would be this way, that all the Bible right up to this page right there, that much of the Bible, is about the ignored creator being rejected. That's the story from Genesis 1 to John 19. The whole scripture from Genesis 1 to John 19 is about our creator who is ignored and rejected. And that's, I mean, if you want to understand what all those prophets and stories and plagues and everything are, it's about, all of it centers on the creator who allows himself to be revealed, is ignored by most people and rejected by almost everyone. And only a few listen to him. Then, right here, this much of the Bible, that's John 20 to Acts 1, talk about the crucified Savior who's risen. It's just a little short section from the tomb story we just read all the way through his ascension. And that central piece, it's so short. I mean, it's at the end of each of the Gospels. But that is the central event of all. It has not very much coverage, but everything's pointing at it from both directions. And then finally, we have the, from Acts chapter 2 right here, through the maps, that is the content of the message of the apostles who all went out and eventually in their messages came to the same point. All of them said that the creator of the universe that you have ignored and rejected came actually as a human and was killed for your sins. Your sins crucified him, and he has risen. And he is the Savior who we'll see in a moment. Paul describes most beautifully. He is the Savior whose arms are outstretched toward every single person. He was talking to pagans, by the way, when he gave this sermon, non-Jews, non-believers, and he said, God's saving arms are extended to you. And if you will reach out toward him, he's not more than one arm's length away. That is the most beautiful picture of Christ in the Bible. That the creator who became the crucified Savior and is risen is now standing and he's got his arms wide open. He's within reach of every person on earth. But you know how they ended their messages? They didn't end it like that. They didn't say, so isn't that nice? They ended it with saying, and if you don't respond and grope after him, he's an angry judge and he's coming in fiery indignation. And if you don't believe in him, you will eternally suffer.